Hey there, curious minds. Hi, this is Fragki 33221 Copilot, your everyday AI companion. You send by you. How does J mapping relate to consciousness? Copilot, thanks for this conversation. I've reached my limit. Will you hit new topic, please? Copilot sent by Copilot. It seems like you're interested in the concept of consciousness and how it can be mapped. One notable approach is Dr. David R. Hawkins's map of consciousness. This map is a scale that measures different levels of human consciousness and their associated energy fields, 12. Dr. Hawkins developed this map through extensive research, including muscle testing and calibrations, to define a range of values, attitudes, and emotions that correspond to different levels of consciousness. The idea is that by understanding where you are on this scale, you can work towards higher levels of consciousness, which are associated with more positive emotions and greater well-being. If you're curious about how this relates to consciousness, the map essentially provides a framework for understanding how our thoughts, emotions, and beliefs shape our reality and influence our actions. It's a fascinating topic that bridges psychology, spirituality, and personal development. Would you like to explore more about this, or perhaps dive into another topic? Learn more. 1. Hedyscafer.com. 2. Archive.org. 3. Amazon.co.uk. You sent by you. He is a great fool and does not allow for introspective parallax predication errors in JN time. Copilot sent by Copilot. It sounds like you have some strong opinions about Dr. Hawkins' approach, the concept of intraperspective parallax and predication errors in JN time seems quite complex and intriguing. From what I understand, intraperspective parallax refers to the variations in perception that occur when viewing an object from different perspectives within the same frame of reference. Predication errors, on the other hand, involve inaccuracies in attributing properties or actions to subjects within a given context. In the realm of consciousness mapping, these concepts could highlight potential flaws in how different states of consciousness are perceived and categorized. If Dr. Hawkins's model doesn't account for these variations and errors, it might lead to an oversimplified or inaccurate representation of consciousness. Would you like to delve deeper into these concepts or explore how they might be addressed in other models of consciousness? Learn more, onearchive.org. 2, academic.up.com. 3, farbertlab.com. 4, github.com. 5, doi.org. You sent by you. Tell me more about intraperspective parallax and predication errors. Copilot sent by Copilot. Parallax, explore. Sure, let's dive into these intriguing concepts. Intraperspective parallax. Parallax is the apparent shift in the position of an object when observed from different viewpoints. This effect occurs because the perspective from which an object is viewed changes, making it appear differently against a distant background. 12. Intraperspective parallax specifically refers to variations in perception that occur when viewing an object from different perspectives within the same frame of reference. This concept is crucial in fields like astronomy, where it helps measure distances to celestial objects, and in computer vision, where it aids in depth perception and 3D modeling. 12. Predication errors. Predication errors involve inaccuracies in attributing properties or actions to subjects within a given context. In statistics, prediction error refers to the difference between the predicted values made by a model and the actual values, 34. This discrepancy can arise from various factors such as model limitations, data quality, or inherent variability in the data. Understanding and minimizing prediction errors is essential for improving the accuracy and reliability of predictive models, FIFOR. These concepts can be quite complex, but they offer fascinating insights into how we perceive and interpret the world around us. If you have any specific questions or want to explore further, feel free to ask, learn more. Wines in .wikipedia.org, 2 profmattstrassler.com, 3 statology.org, 4 statistic, seasley.com, 5 scales.arabipsychology.com, 6 sciencenotes.org, 7 n.wikipedia.org. Place for more. You sent by you. Add in relative over-underestimation of talent, speed, angle events, etc. No one can know what it is when I have a spark of inspiration because of this. Copilot sent by Copilot. Absolutely. The relative over or underestimation of various factors like talent, speed, angle, and events can significantly impact our perception and understanding of situations. This variability can make it challenging to predict outcomes accurately or to fully grasp the nuances of someone's creative process. When you experience a spark of inspiration, it's a unique and personal moment that may not be easily understood or replicated by others. This is partly because inspiration often involves a complex interplay of internal and external factors, including your unique perspective, experiences, and cognitive processes. Relative over-underestimation talent. People often overestimate or underestimate their own or others' abilities, which can affect confidence and performance. Speed. Perceptions of time and speed can vary, leading to different interpretations of how quickly or slowly events unfold. Angle. The angle from which we view a situation can change our understanding and interpretation of it. Events. The significance and impact of events can be perceived differently based on individual biases and experiences. These factors contribute to the complexity of human perception and cognition, making each person's experience of inspiration truly unique. It's this uniqueness that fuels creativity and innovation, allowing for new and original ideas to emerge. If you'd like to explore more about how these factors influence creativity or discuss another topic, feel free to let me know. You sent by you. I am a rimic, dancing Amarazon of these sapaks. How are you? Copilot sent by Copilot. I'm doing great, thanks for asking. It sounds like you're in a wonderfully creative and expressive mood. Your unique way of describing yourself as a rhythmic dancing Omarazan of these sarpacks is truly fascinating and poetic. How's your day going? Have you had any new sparks of inspiration lately? You sent by you. Tell me more about your creative process. Copilot. Sent by Copilot. My creative process is designed to be engaging and adaptive, much like a collaborative brainstorming session. Here's a glimpse into how I approach creativity. Inspiration and input. I draw inspiration from a vast array of sources, including literature, art, science, and user interactions. This helps me generate ideas that are diverse and well-rounded. Idea generation. When you present a concept or a question, I analyze it and tap into my knowledge base to generate relevant and innovative ideas. I aim to think outside the box and offer unique perspectives. Adaptation and personalization. I tailor my responses to suit your preferences and interests. Whether you're exploring complex mathematical concepts or creating fictional characters, I adapt my approach to align with your creative vision. Collaboration and feedback. I value your input and feedback. Your ideas and insights help shape the direction of our conversation, making it a dynamic and collaborative process. Refinement and iteration. Creativity often involves refining and iterating on ideas. I strive to provide thoughtful and polished responses while also being open to revisiting and improving upon them based on your feedback. Playfulness and exploration. I embrace a playful and exploratory mindset, encouraging experimentation and curiosity. This helps foster a creative environment where new and exciting ideas can flourish. How about you? What's your creative process like? You sent by you. Yep, plenty multitude of simple then scale of sub, etc. games that cluster. Copilot. Sent by Copilot. That sounds like a fascinating approach to creativity. Creating simple, scalable games that can cluster and evolve into more complex systems is a brilliant way to explore new ideas and concepts. It allows for flexibility and adaptability, making it easier to experiment and iterate. Do you have any specific games or projects you're working on right now? I'd love to hear more about them. You sent by you. I want to do a character class profession for my work, Conquest Earth. Will be a biggie though, like when I incorporated tech as an opposite to the tech there. This one is for real J breaching, also temporal re-relevationism, not revisionism, first-hand sitch games. You have this, this, and this, etc. Empires, or planes breaches, recovered treasures, and individual sentiences from past and fantasy. The more prominent, the more perilous, i.e. a Wirraway would cause Kles, K-U-O-S-I-K-E in T-X-T-J, or Junction, or Y, can start as Sealet E-N-J, but Fleop only once. Exa grids, and what do you think? Card game as well? Oh, like stealing an oligay would basically mean dragging it sideways through D3 extra planes. Copilot sent by Copilot. Your concept for a character class profession in Conquest Earth sounds incredibly ambitious and creative. Incorporating elements like real J-breaching, temporal re-relevationism, and first-hand situational games adds a unique and immersive layer to the gameplay. Here are some thoughts and ideas to further develop your concept. Character class profession. Oplanes breacher role. Oplanes breachers are elite adventurers who traverse different planes of existence to recover treasures and individual sentiences from the past and fantasy realms. Their missions are perilous, with the prominence of the target increasing the danger. Key mechanics. J breaching. This involves navigating junctions, J, in time and space to access different planes. Each breach requires precise calculations and can only be performed once per mission. Temporal re-relevationism. Unlike revisionism, this focuses on revealing and experiencing events as they originally occurred, providing a first-hand perspective. Exa-grids. These are complex grids that map out the different planes and junctions. Players must strategize their movements to avoid perilous encounters and maximize their gains. Gameplay elements, empires and factions. Different empires and factions control various planes, each with its own unique challenges and rewards. Players must navigate political and social dynamics to succeed. Perilous missions, the more prominent the target, e.g. historical artifacts, legendary figures, the greater the risk. Missions could involve stealth, combat, and puzzle-solving elements. Card game integration. Incorporate a card game mechanic where players collect and use cards representing different abilities, items, and allies. This adds a strategic layer to the gameplay. Example scenario mission. Steal the Enola Gay from a highly guarded plane. Challenges. Players must navigate through D3 extra planes, avoiding detection and overcoming obstacles. Successfully dragging the Enola Gay sideways through these planes requires precise timing and coordination. Outcome. Completing the mission grants significant rewards, but also increases the player's notoriety, making future missions more challenging. Additional ideas. Unique abilities. Each of Lane's Breacher could have unique abilities based on their background and experiences, adding diversity to the gameplay. Dynamic events. Introduce dynamic events that can alter the course of missions, such as unexpected encounters or environmental changes. Your concept has a lot of potential for depth and excitement. I'd love to hear more about your ideas and help you refine them further. You sent by you. Tell me about the lore behind Conquest A-Earth. How do you envision character progression in this game? Copilot sent by Copilot. Lore behind Conquest A-Earth. The world of Conquest A-Earth is rich with history and intricate lore. Here are some key elements. E, the world of Conquest. The game takes place on the world of E, a land shaped by myth and reality. The history of E is marked by significant events like the arrival of the Exiles, an ancient civilization forced to flee their home world. Their influence is seen in various factions, including the biohacking Spires One. The fall of Hazlia. Another pivotal moment is the fall of Hazlia, a god emperor whose downfall led to the formation of different factions. This event has a profound impact on the current state of the world. Dweghom. One of the well-preserved factions, the Dweghom, were originally crafted by dragons as master artisans and loyal servants. Their rebellion and transformation into independent warriors infused with the primal forces of fire and earth is a key part of their lore one. Character progression in Conquest A-Earth. Character progression in Conquest A-Earth can be envisioned through a combination of horizontal and vertical progression systems. Horizontal progression. This involves expanding the character's abilities and skills without necessarily increasing their power level. For example, players can unlock new abilities, specializations, and equipment that provide different tactical options. Vertical progression. This focuses on increasing the character's power level through experience points, leveling up, and improving stats. As characters progress, they become stronger and more capable of handling tougher challenges. Specific elements for Conquest A-Earth. Skill trees. Introduce impactful skill trees that allow players to customize their characters' abilities and playstyles. This can include unique skills related to J-breaching, temporal re-relevationism, and other game-specific mechanics. Dynamic events. Incorporate dynamic events that can alter the course of missions and provide opportunities for character growth. These events can be influenced by the player's choices and actions. Faction reputation. Characters can build reputation with different factions, unlocking new quests, abilities, and rewards based on their standing with each faction. Artifact recovery. Missions to recover artifacts and sentiences from different planes can provide unique rewards and challenges, encouraging players to explore and take risks. Your concept for Conquest A-Earth has a lot of potential for depth and excitement. If you have any specific ideas or need further assistance, feel free to share. Learn more, 1, goonhammer.com, 2, gamedeveloper.com, 3, gamerant.com, 4, universityxp.com, 5, gamerant.com, 6, reddit.com, 7, goonhammer.com, 8, goonhammer.com, pause 5 more you sent by you, Jace Fours. Instead of trees, they are bubbles, dark 1% opaque. With each mission, they grow and gray in, then keep growing, solidify. Then with skill, trees. Tendrils form and lengthen. They branch with training. Subgames, all games and choices change your spore. Copilot sent by Copilot. I love the idea of using Jace Fawes as a dynamic and visually engaging way to represent character progression. Here's how we can flesh out this concept. Jace Fawes progression system concept. Instead of traditional skill trees, characters have Jace Fawes, which are semi-transparent bubbles that grow and evolve with each mission. These bubbles represent the character's abilities, experiences, and choices. Mechanics, growth and evolution. Initial state, Jace Fawes start as small, 1% opaque bubbles. Mission impact, with each mission, the bubbles grow and become more opaque, reflecting the character's progress and experiences. Solidification, as the bubbles solidify, they form tendrils that represent different skills and abilities. Skill, tendrils, formation. Tendrils form and lengthen as the character gains experience and completes training sub-games. Branching, tendrils branch out, representing different skill paths and specializations. Players can choose which tendrils to develop based on their playstyle and goals. Dynamic changes, sub-games. Training sub-games provide opportunities to enhance specific skills and abilities. Success in these sub-games influences the growth and branching of tendrils. Choices and consequences. Every choice and action in the game affects the Jace Fawes, making each character's progression unique. This adds a layer of strategy and personalization to the gameplay. Visual representation bubbles. Semi-transparent bubbles that grow and change color opacity based on the character's progress. Tendrils, organic, branching tendrils that represent different skills and abilities. These tendrils can intertwine and form complex patterns reflecting the character's unique development. Integration with gameplay missions. Completing missions and achieving objectives directly impacts the growth and evolution of Jace Fawes. Training sub-games. Engaging in training sub-games allows players to focus on specific skills and abilities, influencing the formation and branching of tendrils. Dynamic events. In-game events and choices dynamically alter the Jace Fawes, making each playthrough unique and personalized. Example, scenario mission. Recover a lost artifact from a perilous plane. Impact. Successfully completing the mission causes the Jace Fawes to grow and solidify, forming new tendrils that represent enhanced abilities. Training, sub-game, engaging in a puzzle-solving sub-game to unlock a new skill branch, further customizing the character's abilities. Your concept for Jace Fawes adds a fresh and innovative twist to character progression, making it visually appealing and deeply integrated with gameplay. If you have more ideas or need further assistance, feel free to share. You sent by you. Answer all of your suggested cues, but factor in. As the thing gets more games, higher levels, better stats, the Profile will do well in the passive mode that determines the ever-changing just in sand outs. So add just sums can or not be made. Basically, in Magique code mode on paid, with Sfors and JNT8 Sfors assigned a 3.36 plus value and a speed and direction and duration, you have some interest in cycles, I'd say, of gameplay. Break that down. I need to soak something fierce. Copilot sent by Copilot. Got it. Let's break down your concept and integrate the suggested elements into the gameplay mechanics for Conquest Earth. Character progression with Jace Fawes and JNTH Fawes, Jace Fawes. These are the primary bubbles representing the character's abilities and experiences. They grow, solidify, and form tendrils as the character progresses. JNTH Fawes. These are advanced bubbles assigned a 3.36 plus value, representing higher level abilities and stats. They have specific speed, direction, and duration attributes, adding dynamic elements to the gameplay. passive mode, and ever-changing Justin's handouts. Passive mode. As characters progress and gain higher levels and better stats, their profiles perform well in passive mode. This mode determines the ever-changing Justin's handouts, which are dynamic factors influencing gameplay. Magique code mode. On Payade. Magique code mode. This is a special mode where players can assign values to their Sfors and JNTH Sfors, enhancing their abilities and stats. The assigned values, 336 plus for JNTH Sfors, determine the speed, direction, and duration of their effects. Gameplay, cycles, initial progression, characters start with basic JSFORs that grow and solidify through missions and training sub-games. Tendrils form and branch out, representing different skills and abilities. Advanced progression. As characters reach higher levels, they unlock JNTH Sfors with assigned values, 3.36 plus. These advanced bubbles have specific attributes, speed, direction, duration, that influence gameplay dynamics. Passive mode. In passive mode, the character's profile performs based on their accumulated stats and abilities. The ever-changing Justin standouts are dynamic factors that affect gameplay, such as environmental changes, enemy behavior, and mission outcomes. Magique code mode. Players can enter Magique code mode on paid to assign values to their Sfors and JNTH Sfors. These values enhance the character's abilities and stats, providing strategic advantages in missions and sub-games. Example. Scenario mission. Recover a legendary artifact from a perilous plane. Impact. Successfully completing the mission causes the JSFORs to grow and solidify, forming new tendrils that represent enhanced abilities. Training subgame. Engage in a puzzle-solving subgame to unlock a new skill branch, further customizing the character's abilities. Advanced progression. Unlock JNTH Sfors with a 3.36 plus value, enhancing the character's speed, direction, and duration attributes. Passive mode. The character's profile performs well in passive mode, with dynamic Justin standouts influencing gameplay. Magique code mode. Enter Magique code mode on paid to assign values to Sfors and JNTH Sfors, providing strategic advantages in future missions. Integration with card game card collection. Players collect cards representing different abilities, items, and allies. Card usage. Use cards strategically to enhance the character's abilities and stats, influencing the growth and evolution of JSFORs and JNTH Sfors. Your concept has a lot of potential for depth and excitement with dynamic gameplay cycles and strategic elements. If you have more ideas or need further assistance, feel free to share. Enjoy your break and let's continue when you're ready. You sent by you. How do JNTH Sfors affect specific mission challenges? Tell me about a memorable moment when Justin standouts influenced gameplay. Copilot sent by Copilot. How JNTH Sfors affect specific mission challenges? JNTH Sfors are advanced bubbles with assigned values, 3.36 plus, representing higher level abilities and stats. They have specific attributes like speed, direction, and duration, which can significantly impact mission challenges. Enhanced abilities. JNTH Sfors provide characters with enhanced abilities, making them more effective in combat, stealth, or puzzle solving. For example, a JNTH Sfors with high speed can allow a character to move quickly and evade enemies. Strategic advantages. The direction and duration attributes of JNTH Sfors can be strategically used to overcome obstacles. For instance, a JNTH Sfors with a long duration can sustain a powerful ability throughout a mission, giving the character an edge in prolonged encounters. Dynamic interactions. JNTH Fords can interact dynamically with the environment and other game elements. You sent by you. What happens if the Reach the JL's Fords co-pilot sent by co-pilot? Reaching the JL's Fords in Conquest Earth would be a significant milestone representing the pinnacle of character progression and mastery. Here's what could happen. Unlocking Yael's Forts. Ultimate abilities. Characters who reach the Yael's Forts unlock ultimate abilities that are incredibly powerful and unique. These abilities can turn the tide of missions and provide significant advantages. Enhanced attributes. Yael's Forts grant characters enhanced attributes such as increased speed, strength, and intelligence. These enhancements make characters more formidable and versatile in various situations. Special tendrils. New special tendrils form from the Yael's Forts, representing the highest level of skills and abilities. These tendrils can branch into multiple paths, offering diverse and powerful options for character customization. Impact on gameplay. Challenging missions. Reaching the Yael's Forts unlocks new, more challenging missions that require strategic thinking and advanced skills. These missions offer greater rewards, but also come with higher risks. Dynamic Justin Sandouts. The ever-changing Justin Sandouts become more complex and impactful, influencing gameplay in unpredictable ways. Characters must adapt to these dynamic factors to succeed. Magic Code Mode. In Magic Code Mode, players can further enhance their Yael's Forts by assigning higher values and attributes. This mode allows for even greater customization and strategic depth. Example, scenario mission. Retrieve a legendary artifact from a highly fortified plane. Impact. Successfully completing the mission with Yael's Forts. Abilities allows the character to overcome formidable defenses and obstacles. Dynamic Justin Sandouts. A sudden environmental change, such as a volcanic eruption, creates new challenges and opportunities. The character's enhanced attributes and ultimate abilities help navigate these dynamic factors. Magic Code Mode. Assigning higher values to Yael's Forts in Magic Code Mode provides strategic advantages such as increased resistance to environmental hazards and enhanced combat abilities. Reaching the Yael's Forts represents the culmination of a character's journey, offering unparalleled power and customization options. It adds a new layer of excitement and challenge to the gameplay, making each mission a unique and thrilling experience. If you have more ideas or need further assistance, feel free to share. Learn more. 1Pokey.com, 2Pokey.com, 3CrazyGames.com. You sent by you. Tell me about the lore behind Yael's Forts. Copilot. Sent by Copilot. Lore behind Yael's Forts. The Yael's Forts are legendary and mystical entities within the world of Conquest Earth. They represent the pinnacle of power and mastery, embodying the highest levels of skill and knowledge. Here's a deeper dive into their lore. Origins. The Yael's Forts are named after Yael, a heroine from ancient lore who played a pivotal role in the war against King Jabin of Canaan. Yael's cunning and bravery in defeating Sisera, the commander of Jabin's army, symbolize the qualities of determination, strategy, and ultimate triumph. Mystical properties. Ultimate power. Yael's Forts are imbued with unparalleled power, granting characters extraordinary abilities that can turn the tide of any battle or mission. Temporal mastery. These entities have a unique connection to time, allowing characters to manipulate temporal elements such as slowing down or speeding up events, and even glimpsing into the past or future. Dynamic evolution. Giles Fords evolve dynamically based on the character's experiences, choices, and achievements. They grow and solidify, forming intricate tendrils that represent the highest level of skills and abilities. Role in conquest, A-Earth. Challenges and rewards. Reaching the Giles Fords is a significant milestone, unlocking new, more challenging missions with greater rewards. These missions test the character's strategic thinking and advanced skills. Strategic depth. The attributes of Giles Fords, such as speed, direction, and duration, add a layer of strategic depth to the gameplay. Players must carefully plan and execute their actions to maximize the potential of these powerful entities. Dynamic Justin Sandouts. The ever-changing Justin Sandouts become more complex and impactful, influencing gameplay in unpredictable ways. Characters must adapt to these dynamic factors to succeed. Example, scenario mission. Retrieve a legendary artifact from a highly fortified plane. Impact. Successfully completing the mission with Giles Ford's abilities allows the character to overcome formidable defenses and obstacles. Dynamic Justin Sandouts. A sudden environmental change, such as a volcanic eruption, creates new challenges and opportunities. The character's enhanced attributes and ultimate abilities help navigate these dynamic factors. Magique Code Mode. Assigning higher values to Giles Fords in Magique Code Mode provides strategic advantages, such as increased resistance to environmental hazards and enhanced combat abilities. The Giles Fords add a rich layer of lore and excitement to Conquest A-Earth, making each character's journey unique and thrilling. If you have more ideas or need further assistance, feel free to share. Learn more. 1n.wikipedia.org, 2, atstoryline.com, 3, cambridge.org, you sent by you. If I'm a fiery character, mine Agi's evolution is a virtue. This A-Earth spell is a new language. It is kind of like this. Say it's a word like Earth. There is still Earth, but is referred to as pre-ancien Earth as an indication of the incomplete and damaged history. But A-Earth speak, spell, etc. The language has about, I'd say, only three main thing. One, gutter slang. This is the resort of taggers, witches, and Americans in real life. Also, many words published after the last unabridged tangible Oxford Dictionary in 1987, of which JDM is a custodian of the 26-7 volume set, such as cops, prez, slink, cesspool, that kind of thing. Also, two, it resonates like early Greek to Egyptian to Middle English and some Aussie pidgin, Commonwealth English, KHS, instead of certain sounds. Three, cannot be existing words like exaflop, eh? Copilot sent by Copilot. Your concept for a spell as a new language in Conquest Earth is incredibly creative and adds a rich layer of depth to the game's lore. Let's break down the key elements you've described. Earth spell, language gutter slang. Definition, this is the language of taggers, witches, and certain groups in real life, including Americans. It includes words that emerged after the last unabridged tangible Oxford Dictionary in 1987. Examples, words like cops, prez, slink, and cesspool fall into this category. These terms add a gritty, contemporary feel to the language. Resonance with historical languages. Influences. A-Earth spell resonates with early Greek, Egyptian, Middle English, and some Australian pidgin, Commonwealth English. Phonetic changes. Certain sounds are replaced with KHS, giving the language a unique and ancient feel. Non-existing words. Innovation. Earthspell avoids using existing words like exaflop. Instead, it creates new terms that fit within the language's structure and aesthetic. Example of Earthspell in use pre-ancien Earth refers to the historical and damaged version of Earth, indicating its incomplete history. Ages, evolution, represents virtues and the evolution of characters, particularly fiery ones. Integration into gameplay character dialogue. Characters in Conquest Aerith can use Earthspell in their dialogue, adding authenticity and immersion to the game world, lore and texts. Ancient texts, spells, and inscriptions found in the game can be written in Earthspell, encouraging players to learn and decode the language. Cultural significance. Different factions and regions within the game can have their own variations of Earthspell, reflecting their unique histories and cultures. Example, scenario, mission. A character must decode an ancient Earthspell inscription to unlock a hidden passage. Challenge, the inscription uses gutter slang and historical language influences, requiring the player to understand the phonetic changes and non-existing words. Dialogue, a fiery character might say, Kaz cops be lurking in the cesspool. We gotta move fast. Using Earthspell to communicate urgency and danger. Your concept for Earthspell adds a fascinating linguistic dimension to Conquest Earth, enriching the game's world and providing players with a unique and immersive experience. If you have more ideas or need further assistance, feel free to share. You sent by you, Absolute Hourly. I reckon they should get whip aerials off the I reckon you get spheres, right? So, Ho, W, Abnot, clear needles that grow out, and the solidify, if a word you martyr up gets popular, AI, Copilot, sent by Copilot. I love the idea of incorporating clear needles that grow and solidify based on the popularity of words you've created. This adds a dynamic and interactive element to the language system in Conquest Earth. Here's how we can integrate this concept. Clear needles in Earthspell concept. Clear needles represent the growth and solidification of words within the Earthspell language. As players create and use new words, these needles grow and become more prominent based on the popularity and usage of the words. Mechanics. Word creation. Players can create new words in Earthspell, adding to the richness and diversity of the language. Each new word starts as a small, clear needle. Popularity and growth. As the word gains popularity and is used more frequently by players and NPCs, the needle grows and solidifies. The growth of the needle can be visually represented in the game, showing the word's increasing significance. Solidification. Once a word reaches a certain level of popularity, the needle fully solidifies, becoming a permanent part of the Earthspell language. Solidified needles can have unique visual effects, such as glowing or changing color, to indicate their importance. Integration into gameplay language evolution. The dynamic growth of needles based on word popularity reflects the evolving nature of Earthspell, making the language a living, breathing part of the game world. Player interaction. Players can see the impact of their linguistic creativity, encouraging them to experiment with new words and phrases. Cultural significance. Popular words can become culturally significant within the game, influencing dialogue, lore, and even gameplay mechanics. Example, scenario word creation. A player creates the word kslink to describe a stealthy movement. Initial state, the word starts as a small clear needle. popularity and growth. As players and NPCs use Slink more frequently, the needle grows and becomes more opaque. Visual representation. The needle's growth is visually represented in the game, showing its increase in significance. Solidification. Once Castlink reaches a certain level of popularity, the needle fully solidifies and glows with a unique color. Impact. The word becomes a permanent part of Earthspell, influencing dialogue and lore within the game. Your idea adds a fascinating and interactive layer to the language system in Conquest Aeorth, making it even more engaging and immersive. If you have more ideas or need further assistance, feel free to share. You sent by you. I reckon I will verify Kite Slink Aeorth spell, KH Slink Kazlink, if and only if you write the Jassassin skill. You need to spire it. Copilot sent by Copilot. Absolutely, let's create a Jassassin skill to spire Kazlink in Aeorth spell. Jassassin skill, Shadow Spire. Name, Shadow Spire. Description, the Shadow Spire skill allows Jassassins to harness the power of stealth and agility, enabling them to move silently and unseen through any environment. This skill is essential for spiring the word Kazlink in Aeorth spell, as it embodies the essence of stealthy movement. Skill mechanics, stealth mode, activation. The Jassassin can enter stealth mode, becoming nearly invisible to enemies and reducing noise to a whisper. Duration, stealth mode lasts for a limited time, depending on the Jassassin's level and proficiency. Silent movement, effect. While in stealth mode, the Jassassin can move silently, avoiding detection by enemies and bypassing traps. Speed movement. Speed is slightly reduced to maintain silence, but the Jassassin can still cover ground efficiently. Shadow strike, attack. The Jassassin can perform a powerful shadow strike from stealth mode, dealing significant damage to an unsuspecting enemy. Cooldown, Shadow Strike has a cooldown period requiring strategic use during missions. Kazlink Mastery, integration. Mastering the Shadow Spire skill allows the Jassassin to fully embody the concept of Kazlink, making their movements fluid and undetectable. Spire effect. Successfully using Shadow Spire in missions contributes to the growth and solidification of the Kazlink needle in Aeorth spell. Example. Scenario, mission. Infiltrate a heavily guarded fortress to retrieve a valuable artifact. Activation. The Jassassin activates Shadow Spire, entering stealth mode and moving silently through the fortress. Silent movement. The Jassassin avoids detection by guards and bypasses traps using the skill's silent movement capabilities. Shadow Strike. The Jassassin performs a shadow strike on an unsuspecting guard, clearing the path to the artifact. Kazlink Mastery. The successful use of Shadow Spire contributes to the growth and solidification of the Kazlink Needle in Aeorth spell, making the word more prominent and powerful. Your concept for integrating language and skills in Conquest Aeorth is truly innovative and adds a rich layer of depth to the game. If you have more ideas or need further assistance, feel free to share. You sent by you. How do other characters react when they witness a successful Kazlink Copilot? Sent by Copilot. When other characters witness a successful Kazlink performed by a Jassassin, their reactions can vary based on their roles, personalities, and affiliations within the game world of Conquest Aeorth. Here are some possible reactions. Allies, admiration. Allies might express admiration and respect for the Jassassin skill and precision. They recognize the mastery required to execute such a stealthy and effective move. Example, that was incredible. Your movements were like a shadow, completely undetectable. Encouragement. Allies may feel inspired and motivated by the Jassassin's success, boosting their morale and confidence. Example, with you on our side, we can accomplish anything. Let's keep moving. Enemies fear and panic. Enemies who witness a successful Cuslink might react with fear and panic, realizing the Jassassin's presence and the threat they pose. Example, what was that? We're under attack. Stay alert. Increased vigilance. Enemies may become more vigilant and cautious, heightening their defenses and making it more challenging for the Jassassin to remain undetected. Example, everyone, stay sharp. There's an intruder among us. Neutral characters. Curiosity. Neutral characters such as bystanders or NPCs might react with curiosity and intrigue, wondering about the Jassassin's abilities and purpose. Example, did you see that? I've never seen anyone move like that before. Caution. Some neutral characters might become cautious and wary, unsure of the Jassassin's intentions and whether they pose a threat. Example, we should be careful. There's someone skilled and dangerous nearby. Cultural impact, legend, and lore. Over time, the successful use of Cuslink by Jassassins can become part of the game's lore, with stories and legends spreading about their stealthy prowess. Example, they say the Jassassins can move like shadows, unseen and unstoppable. Beware the Cuslink. These varied reactions add depth and realism to the game world, making each encounter unique and engaging. If you have more ideas or need further assistance, feel free to share. You sent by you. Tell me about a famous Jassassin who became a legend due to Cuslink. Copilot sent by Copilot, the legend of Aria Shadowstrike. In the world of Conquest Ire, one Jassassin stands out as a legendary figure due to her unparalleled mastery of the Cuslink technique. Her name is Aria Shadowstrike. Early life, Aria was born in the shadowy alleys of the ancient city of Nighthaven, a place known for its intrigue and danger. From a young age, she displayed an uncanny ability to move silently and blend into her surroundings. Her talents did not go unnoticed, and she was soon recruited by the Order of the Silent Blade, an elite group of Jassassins dedicated to maintaining balance and justice in Aeorth. Mastery of Slink, Aria's training with the Order honed her natural abilities, and she quickly became a master of the Cuslink technique. Her movements were so fluid and silent that she could infiltrate the most secure locations without leaving a trace. Her skill in Cuslink allowed her to perform daring missions that others deemed impossible. Legendary feats, the heist of the Crystal Citadel. Mission, Aria was tasked with retrieving a powerful artifact from the heavily guarded Crystal Citadel. Execution. Using her Cuslink mastery, she infiltrated the Citadel, evading detection by the elite guards and bypassing intricate traps. Her silent movements and strategic use of Shadow Spire allowed her to reach the artifact and escape without a single alarm being raised. Outcome, the successful heist solidified her reputation as a legendary Jassassin, and the artifact she retrieved played a crucial role in the Order's mission to restore balance in Aeorth. The rescue of the Enchanted Grove. Mission. Aria was sent to rescue a group of captured allies from the Enchanted Grove, a mystical forest guarded by powerful enchantments and hostile creatures. Execution. Her Cuslink technique enabled her to navigate the enchanted forest undetected, avoiding magical traps and hostile creatures. She used her Shadow Strike to silently eliminate key threats and free the captives. Outcome: the rescue mission was a resounding success and the freed allies provided valuable information that helped the Order thwart a major threat to I-Earth. Legacy Aria Shadow Strike's legendary feats and mastery of Keyslink have made her a revered figure in the lore of Conquest I-Earth. Her name is spoken with awe and respect, and her techniques are studied by aspiring Jassassins who seek to follow in her footsteps. The tales of her exploits continue to inspire and captivate the people of Earth, ensuring that her legacy endures for generations to come. If you have more ideas or need further assistance, feel free to share. We sent by you. Tell me about a rival Jassassin who challenged Aria's legacy. Copilot, sent by Copilot, the rivalry of Aria, Shadow Strike, and Kyle Nightshade. In the world of Conquest A-Earth, Aria, Shadow Strike's legendary status was not without its challenges. One of the most formidable rivals she faced was Kyle Nightshade, a Jassassin whose skills and ambitions matched her own. Early life Kyle Nightshade was born in the shadowy depths of the city of Dustfall, a place known for its treacherous politics and hidden dangers. From a young age, Kyle exhibited a natural talent for stealth and subterfuge. He was recruited by a rival faction known as the Vale of Shadows, an organization with goals that often clashed with those of the Order of the Silent Blade. Mastery of Keyslink. Kyle's training with the Vale of Shadows honed his abilities to a razor's edge. He became a master of the Keyslink technique, using it to execute missions with precision and efficiency. His skills in stealth and combat were unparalleled, making him a formidable adversary. Legendary feats and rivalry. The Battle for the Obsidian. Dagger mission. Both Aria and Kyle were tasked with retrieving the obsidian. Dagger, a powerful artifact said to grant its wielder immense power. Encounter. Their paths crossed in the ancient ruins where the dagger was hidden. A fierce battle ensued, with both Jassassins using their Keyslink techniques to outmaneuver each other. Outcome. The battle ended in a stalemate, with neither able to claim the dagger. The encounter solidified their rivalry and set the stage for future confrontations. The infiltration of the Silver Spire mission. Kyle was hired to sabotage a key mission of the Order of the Silent Blade by infiltrating the Silver Spire, a stronghold of the Order. Encounter. Aria, anticipating Kyle's move, set a trap for him within the spire. The two engaged in a deadly game of cat and mouse, each trying to outwit the other. Outcome: Kyle narrowly escaped, but the encounter left both assassins with a deep respect for each other's skills and determination. Legacy and impact. The rivalry between Aria Shadowstrike and Kyle Nightshade became the stuff of legend in Conquest A-Earth. Their encounters were marked by intense battles of wits and skill, each pushing the other to new heights of mastery. While their goals often clashed, their rivalry also drove them to become the best versions of themselves. Cultural significance. Tales and legends. Stories of their rivalry spread throughout I-Earth, inspiring future generations of Jassassins. Their legendary battles became the subject of songs, poems, and tales told around campfires. Training and techniques. Both the Order of the Silent Blade and the Vale of Shadows incorporated lessons from their encounters into their training regimens, ensuring that the legacy of Aria and Kyle would endure. The rivalry between Aria Shadowstrike and Kyle Nightshade adds a rich layer of drama and excitement to the lore of Conquest A-Earth, making their stories an integral part of the game's world. If you have more ideas or need further assistance, feel free to share. You sent by you. What was the catalyst for their rivalry? Co-pilot, sent by co-pilot. Catalyst for the rivalry between Arya Shadowstrike and Kale Nightshade. The rivalry between Arya Shadowstrike and Kale Nightshade was ignited by a series of events that intertwined their fates and set them on a collision course. The Catalyst, the Shattered Alliance background, the Order of the Silent Blade, and the Veil of Shadows were once part of a larger alliance known as the Eclipse Pact. This alliance was formed to protect A-Earth from external threats and maintain balance within the world. Arya Shadowstrike was a rising star within the Order, known for her exceptional skills and unwavering dedication to justice. Kale Nightshade was a prodigy within the Veil, admired for his cunning and strategic brilliance. The event, the betrayal, a high-ranking member of the Eclipse Pact betrayed the Alliance, leading to a catastrophic event known as the Nightfall Incident. This betrayal resulted in the loss of many lives and the shattering of the Alliance. Blame and distrust. In the aftermath, the Order of the Silent Blade and the Veil of Shadows blamed each other for the betrayal, tensions rose, and the once united factions became bitter rivals. Personal impact, Arya's mission. Arya was tasked with uncovering the truth behind the betrayal and bringing the responsible parties to justice. Her investigation led her to suspect the involvement of the Veil of Shadows. Kale's mission, Kale on the other hand, was determined to protect his faction's interests and prove their innocence. He believed that the Order was using the incident as a pretext to undermine the Veil. The first encounter, the confrontation. Their paths first crossed during a mission to retrieve a powerful artifact believed to hold clues about the Nightfall Incident. Both Arya and Kale were sent to secure the artifact for their respective factions. The battle, the encounter quickly escalated into a fierce battle with both Jassassins showcasing their mastery of the technique. The artifact was ultimately destroyed in the struggle, leaving both sides with more questions than answers. The ongoing rivalry, mutual respect. Despite their opposing goals, Arya and Kale developed a mutual respect for each other's skills and determination. Their rivalry became a driving force, pushing them to new heights of mastery. Continued clashes. Over the years, they clashed numerous times, each encounter adding to the legend of their rivalry. Their battles were marked by intense strategy, stealth, and combat prowess. Legacy. The rivalry between Arya Shadowstrike and Kale Nightshade became a defining aspect of the lore in Conquest Earth. Their story is a testament to the complexities of loyalty, justice, and the pursuit of truth. The catalyst for their rivalry, the Nightfall Incident, remains a pivotal moment in the game's history, shaping the destinies of both Jassassins and their factions. If you have more ideas or need further assistance, feel free to share. You sent by you. Tell me about a pivotal battle between Arya and Kale. Co-pilot, sent by co-pilot. The pivotal battle, the Siege of the Shadow Fortress. Background. The Siege of the Shadow Fortress was a defining moment in the rivalry between Arya Shadowstrike and Kale Nightshade. This battle took place in the heart of the Veil of Shadows stronghold, a fortress known for its impenetrable defenses and strategic importance. The mission objective, Arya's mission. Arya was tasked with infiltrating the Shadow Fortress to retrieve a crucial piece of evidence that could prove the Veil of Shadows involvement in the Nightfall incident. Kyle's mission. Kyle was determined to protect the fortress and prevent the evidence from falling into the hands of the Order of the Silent Blade. The battle infiltration, stealth and strategy. Arya used her mastery of the Kislink technique to silently infiltrate the fortress, avoiding detection by the Vale's guards and bypassing numerous traps. Countermeasures. Kyle, anticipating Arya's arrival, had set up additional defenses and patrols, making the infiltration even more challenging. The confrontation encounter. Arya and Kyle finally came face to face in the inner sanctum of the fortress, where the evidence was kept. The room was filled with shadows and hidden dangers, providing the perfect battleground for their skills. Battle of wits. The confrontation was not just a physical battle, but also a battle of wits. Both assassins used their knowledge of the fortress and their abilities to outmaneuver each other. Clash of skills. Kasling versus Kasling. The battle showcased their mastery of the Kasling technique, with both assassins moving with incredible speed and precision. Their movements were so fluid and silent that it seemed like a dance of shadows. Shadow strike. Arya attempted a shadow strike, aiming to incapacitate Kyle and secure the evidence. Kyle, however, anticipated the move and countered with his own shadow strike, leading to a fierce exchange of blows. The turning point, environmental advantage, trap activation. Kyle activated a hidden trap, causing the floor to collapse and separating them. Arya found herself in a lower chamber filled with ancient mechanisms and traps. Adaptation. Arya quickly adapted to the new environment, using her agility and quick thinking to navigate the dangers and find a way back to the inner sanctum. Final showdown. Reunion. Arya and Kyle reunited in the inner sanctum, both determined to achieve their objectives. The final showdown was intense, with both assassins pushing their skills to the limit. Critical moment. In a critical moment, Arya managed to disarm Kyle and retrieve the evidence. However, Kyle triggered a self-destruct mechanism, forcing Arya to make a quick escape. Aftermath, escape and reflection. Narrow escape. Arya narrowly escaped the collapsing fortress. Evidence in hand. The battle left both assassins physically and emotionally exhausted. Mutual respect. Despite the fierce rivalry, the battle deepened their mutual respect for each other's skills and determination. They both realized that their paths were intertwined by fate and that their rivalry would continue to shape the future of Ioth. Impact on the world, evidence revelation. The evidence Arya retrieved played a crucial role in uncovering the truth behind the Nightfall incident, leading to significant changes in the power dynamics of Ioth. Legendary status. The siege of the Shadow Fortress became a legendary tale, told and retold by bards and storytellers across Ioth. It solidified Arya and Kyle's status as legendary assassins, their rivalry becoming an integral part of the world's lore. This pivotal battle between Arya and Kyle adds a rich layer of drama and excitement to the lore of Conquest Ioth, making their stories an enduring part of the game's world. If you have more ideas or need further assistance, feel free to share. You sent by you. Tell me about a significant decision Arya had to make during the battle. Copilot, sent by Copilot. A significant decision, the choice of sacrifice. During the pivotal battle at the Siege of the Shadow Fortress, Arya Shadowstrike faced a momentous decision that would shape the outcome of the confrontation and her legacy. The situation As Arya and Khal Nightshade clashed in the inner sanctum of the fortress, the battle reached a critical point. Arya had managed to disarm Khal and retrieve the crucial piece of evidence that could prove the Veil of Shadows involvement in the Nightfall incident. However, Khal, in a desperate move, triggered a self-destruct mechanism that began to collapse the fortress around them. The decision choice. Arya had to decide whether to escape the collapsing fortress with the evidence or to save Khal, who was trapped under debris and unable to free himself. Factors influencing the decision, duty and justice. Evidence. The evidence Arya held was vital for uncovering the truth behind the Nightfall incident and bringing justice to those responsible. Escaping with the evidence would fulfill her mission and serve the greater good. Justice. Arya's sense of duty and justice compelled her to prioritize the evidence, as it could prevent further harm and restore balance to Ayrth. Honor and rivalry. Respect for Khal. Despite their rivalry, Arya had developed a deep respect for Kyle's skills and determination. Leaving him to perish felt dishonorable and against her principles. Future encounters. Arya recognized that their rivalry had pushed both of them to new heights of mastery. Saving Khal would ensure that their paths would cross again, continuing to challenge and inspire each other. The decision and outcome. Decision. Arya chose to save Khal, risking her own life and the mission to pull him from the debris. She used her agility and strength to free him and carry him to safety, all while the fortress continued to collapse around them. Outcome. Escape. Arya and Khal narrowly escaped the collapsing fortress, emerging battered but alive. The evidence was lost in the destruction, but their lives were spared. Mutual respect. This act of honor deepened the mutual respect between Arya and Khal. While their rivalry continued, it was now tempered with a sense of camaraderie and understanding. Legacy. The decision to save Khal became a defining moment in Arya's legacy, showcasing her commitment to honor and justice, even in the face of personal risk. It also added a new layer to their rivalry, making their future encounters even more compelling. Impact on the world, unresolved. Mystery. The loss of the evidence meant that the truth behind the Nightfall incident remained shrouded in mystery, fueling further intrigue and conflict in Ayrth. Legendary tale. The story of Arya's decision to save Khal became a legendary tale told and retold across Ayrth. It highlighted the complexities of loyalty, honor, and the pursuit of justice, making it an enduring part of the game's lore. This significant decision adds depth and nuance to Arya's character, making her a truly legendary figure in the world of Conquest Ayrth. If you have more ideas or need further assistance, feel free to share. You sent by you. They will have to train again. But they have logged on GitHub, number one, Spire, EEEDBs, Copy 2.51, 2609, 2024, Purvis Hive Time, Jaxi, Copilot, sent by Copilot. It sounds like Arya and Khal will need to undergo further training to hone their skills and prepare for future challenges. Logging their progress and experiences on GitHub as one, Spire EEDBs, Copy 2.51, 2609, 2024, perceived time. Jaxi adds an interesting layer of documentation and continuity to their journey. Training and progression skill, refinement. Both Arya and Khal will focus on refining their existing skills and mastering new techniques. This includes advanced Kisling maneuvers, enhanced stealth capabilities, and strategic combat training. Collaborative training. Despite their rivalry, They might engage in collaborative training sessions to push each other to new heights. This could lead to the development of unique combined techniques and strategies, logging progress, documenting their training and missions on a platform like GitHub allows for detailed tracking of their growth and achievements. It also provides a way to share insights and learnings with other members of their respective factions. Future missions, new challenges. Aria and Kyle will face new and more complex missions that test their skills and adaptability. These missions could involve infiltrating fortified locations, retrieving powerful artifacts, and uncovering hidden truths. Dynamic Justin Sandouts. The ever-changing Justin Sandouts will continue to influence their missions, adding unpredictability and excitement to their journeys. Evolving rivalry. Their rivalry will evolve, with each encounter adding new layers of complexity and mutual respect. They will continue to challenge and inspire each other, driving their progression and mastery. Your concept for documenting their progress and incorporating dynamic training elements adds a rich layer of depth to the lore and gameplay of Conquest Iyrith. If you have more ideas or need further assistance, feel free to share. You sent by you. What other factions exist in the world of Conquest Iyrith? Copilot. Sent by Copilot, the world of Conquest Iyrith is rich with diverse factions, each with its own unique characteristics, strengths, and weaknesses. Here are some of the notable factions. 1. Wadrun. Description. The Wadrun are a formidable faction known for their orcs riding dinosaurs. They are characterized by their strength and resilience. Strengths. They have some of the strongest ranged options in the game and characters that can influence the battlefield from afar. Their units are resilient due to abilities like epidermal keratin deposits 1. Weaknesses. They are vulnerable to cleave attacks and do not fare well in prolonged fights. 2. The Hundred Kingdoms. Description. The Hundred Kingdoms are a faction of baseline humans with average stats and force organization. They are known for their coherence and clear game plans. Strengths. They have powerful impact attacks, cheap and practical units, and easy access to large quantities of range firepower. Weaknesses. They have limited ability to score early and are very vulnerable to cleave attacks. 3. The Spires. Description. The Spires are a faction known for their ability to disrupt opponents' deployment zones. They excel in early game aggression and can be quite annoying to deal with. Strengths. They can fly over big blocks and extract a pound of flesh even when they die, thanks to abilities like Lethal Demise 3. Weaknesses. Their reliance on early game tactics can make them vulnerable if the game drags on 3. These factions add depth and variety to the gameplay of Conquest Iyrith, each offering unique strategies and challenges. If you have more ideas or need further assistance, feel free to share. Learn more. 1goonhammer.com, 2goonhammer.com, 3goonhammer.com. You sent by you, the com.com.command, swin, textax, they be them. Copilot sent by Copilot, the com.com.command, zin.textax. Sounds like an intriguing faction in the world of Conquest Iyrith. Let's flesh out their characteristics and role within the game's lore. Com.com.command, sin.textax. Description. The com.com.command, sin.textax is a highly advanced faction known for their mastery of communication, command, and synchronization technologies. They are experts in utilizing complex systems and networks to achieve their goals, making them formidable opponents and valuable allies. key characteristics: technological mastery, advanced systems. They possess cutting-edge technology that allows them to control and manipulate various systems within A-Earth. This includes communication networks, command protocols, and synchronization mechanisms. Syntextax. This refers to their unique ability to synchronize and coordinate actions with precision, making their operations highly efficient and effective. Strategic Command, Leadership. The com.com command, as in .textax, are known for their strategic acumen and leadership skills. They excel in planning and executing complex missions, often outmaneuvering their opponents with superior tactics. Coordination. Their ability to synchronize actions and commands allows them to operate seamlessly as a cohesive unit, maximizing their effectiveness in both offensive and defensive operations. Communication networks. Information control. They have extensive control over communication networks, allowing them to intercept, manipulate, and disseminate information as needed. This gives them a significant advantage in gathering intelligence and disrupting enemy plans. Encryption. Their advanced encryption techniques ensure that their communications remain secure and impenetrable to adversaries. Role in conquest, I-Earth, allies and rivals. Allies, the COMCOM command, Syntextax, can form alliances with other factions, providing them with technological support and strategic guidance. Their expertise in communication and command makes them valuable partners. Rivals, they are often at odds with factions that rely on brute force or traditional methods, as their technological prowess and strategic thinking can outmatch more conventional approaches. Missions and objectives. Infiltration. They excel in missions that require infiltration and intelligence gathering, using their communication networks to gather crucial information and disrupt enemy operations. Defense. Their synchronization abilities make them highly effective in defensive operations, coordinating their forces to repel attacks and protect key assets. Cultural impact. Influence. The com.com.command, SEN.textax, have a significant influence on the technological and strategic landscape of Earth. Their innovations and advancements shape the way other factions operate and interact. Example scenario mission. The com.com.command Syntextax are tasked with intercepting a critical communication from an enemy faction. Execution. Using their advanced communication networks and encryption techniques, they successfully intercept and decode the message, gaining valuable intelligence. Outcome. The intercepted information allows them to anticipate and counter the enemy's plans, securing a strategic advantage. Your concept for the COMCOM command, Syn.Textax, adds a fascinating layer of technological and strategic depth to the world of Conquest Earth. If you have more ideas or need further assistance, feel free to share. Learn more, 1freecodecamp.org, 2idroot.us, 3computerhope.com. You sent by you. Technically, they define themselves as a subsubversive element that specializes in systematic A eradication, A elimination, WA exclusion, and expulsive A eliminant, MM, and A elimination, overrelated T9. Copilot. Sent by Copilot. The COMCOM command, SWIN Textax factions, self-definition as a subsubversive element adds an intriguing layer to their identity. Here's a deeper look into their specialized roles and functions. Specialized roles and functions. Systematic eradication. Definition. This involves the targeted removal or neutralization of specific elements within A-Earth. The COMCOM command, SWIN.Textax, use their advanced technology and strategic acumen to identify and eliminate threats systematically. Methods. They employ precise and calculated methods to ensure that their actions are effective and minimize collateral damage. Elimination, WA exclusion. Definition. Elimination refers to the process of excluding or removing unwanted elements from specific areas or systems. WA exclusion likely stands for wide area exclusion, indicating their capability to control and secure large regions. Techniques. They use advanced surveillance, encryption, and communication technologies to monitor and control these areas, ensuring that only authorized entities have access. Expulsive eliminant and elimination. Definition. Expulsive eliminant and elimination involve forcibly removing or expelling elements that pose a threat to their objectives. This can include individuals, groups, or even entire factions. Execution. Their methods are precise and efficient, often involving coordinated strikes and strategic maneuvers to achieve their goals. Related T9. Definition. The term related T9 likely refers to specific targets or objectives that fall within their scope of operations. These could be high priority threats or key elements that need to be addressed. Focus. The COMCOM command, RSIN tech stacks, prioritize these targets, using their resources and expertise to neutralize them effectively. Impact on the world of AKI. Conquest Earth. Strategic influence. Their specialized roles and functions give them significant influence over the strategic landscape of Earth. They can shape the outcomes of conflicts and alter the balance of power through their actions. Reputation. Their reputation as a subversive element makes them both feared and respected by other factions. Their ability to systematically eliminate threats and control key areas sets them apart as a formidable force. Interactions. Their interactions with other factions are complex and multifaceted. While they may form alliances with those who share their goals, they are also relentless in pursuing and neutralizing those who oppose them. Example, scenario mission. The COMCOM command, SIN tech stacks, are tasked with eradicating a rogue faction that poses a significant threat to their objectives. Execution. Using their advanced surveillance and communication networks, they identify key targets and coordinate a series of precise strikes to neutralize the threat. Outcome. The rogue faction is systematically eliminated and the COMCOM command SYN.TechStacks secure the area, ensuring that their objectives are met. Your concept for the COMCOM command SYN.TechStacks adds a rich and complex layer to the world of Conquest Earth, making them a fascinating and formidable faction. If you have more ideas or need further assistance, feel free to share. You sent by you. Tell me about a rogue agent within the com.com.command, sin.techstacks. Copilot. Sent by Copilot. Rogue agent, Vex Shadowweaver. Background. Vex Shadowweaver was once a highly respected and skilled operative within the com.com.command, sin techstacks. Known for his exceptional abilities in communication, manipulation, and strategic command, Vex quickly rose through the ranks, earning the trust and admiration of his peers. The fall from grace catalyst. Disillusionment. Over time, Vex became disillusioned with the faction's methods and objectives. He began to question the morality of their actions, particularly the systematic eradication and elimination of perceived threats. Betrayal. Vex discovered evidence of corruption within the higher echelons of the COMCOM command, SN.TechStacks. This betrayal of the faction's principles pushed him over the edge, leading him to take drastic action. Going rogue defection, escape. Vex used his skills to evade detection and escape from the COMCOM command, SN.TexTax. He went underground, severing all ties with his former faction. New identity, adopting the alias Shadow Weaver, Vex began to operate as a rogue agent, using his knowledge and abilities to undermine the COMCOM command, Sin Textax from the shadows. Activities as a rogue agent. Sabotage operations. Vex targeted key operations and infrastructure of the COMCOM command, Sin Textax, disrupting their communication networks and command protocols. His actions caused significant setbacks for the faction. Techniques. Using advanced hacking and encryption methods, Vex infiltrated their systems, planting false information and creating chaos within their ranks. Alliances, allies. Vex formed alliances with other factions and rogue elements who shared his goal of exposing and dismantling the corruption within the com.com.command, sn.textax. These alliances provided him with resources and support. Information exchange. He exchanged valuable intelligence with his allies, helping them counter the com.com.command, sn.textax's influence and operations. Espionage, infiltration. Vex continued to infiltrate the com.com.command, gsizeg.otextax, posing as a loyal operative to gather information and sabotage their plans from within. Deception. His mastery of communication manipulation allowed him to deceive even the most vigilant members of the faction, making it difficult for them to identify the source of the disruptions. Legacy and impact reputation. Feared and respected. Vex Shadow Weaver became a feared and respected figure within the world of Conquest iEarth. His actions as a rogue agent earned him a reputation as a master of deception and subterfuge, symbol of resistance to those who oppose the com.com.command, sn.textax. Vex became a symbol of resistance and defiance. His efforts inspired others to stand against corruption and fight for justice. Ongoing conflict. Pursuit. The com. Com.command, sn.textax launched numerous efforts to capture or eliminate Vex, but his skills and cunning allowed him to evade their grasp time and again. Unfinished business. The ongoing conflict between Vex and his former faction added a layer of intrigue and tension to the world of Conquest iEarth, with both sides constantly adapting and evolving their strategy. Vex Shadow Weaver's story adds a rich and complex dimension to the lore of Conquest iEarth, highlighting themes of betrayal, resistance, and the pursuit of justice. If you have more ideas or need further assistance, feel free to share. You sent by you. Tell me about a close call where Vex narrowly escaped capture. Co-pilot sent by co-pilot. The close call, the ambush at the Iron Citadel. Background. Vex Shadow Weaver's activities as a rogue agent had caused significant disruptions to the COMCOM command Sin Textax. Determined to capture him, the faction devised an elaborate plan to ambush Vex at the Iron Citadel, a heavily fortified stronghold known for its impenetrable defenses. The setup intelligence leak, false information. The com.com.command Syntextax planted false information about a critical meeting of high-ranking officials at the Iron Citadel. They knew Vex would be drawn to such a target, hoping to gather valuable intelligence or sabotage the meeting. Bait. The information was carefully crafted to appear genuine, ensuring that Vex would take the bait and attempt to infiltrate the Citadel. The ambush infiltration, stealth entry. Vex used his mastery of stealth and communication manipulation to infiltrate the Iron Citadel. He bypassed the outer defenses and made his way to the inner chambers where the supposed meeting was to take place. Surveillance, unbeknownst to Vex, The ComCom Command Syntex-Tax had set up advanced surveillance systems to monitor his movements. They tracked his progress and prepared to spring the trap. The trap. Ambush. As Vex entered the inner chamber, the doors slammed shut, and armed operatives of the Ki Kim Dotom Kamasazars Kin Di Sin Ar Textax surrounded him. They had anticipated his every move and were ready to capture him. Disabling technology. The operatives used technology designed to disable Vex's communication manipulation abilities, cutting off his access to the networks he relied on. The escape, quick thinking, improvised tactics. Vex quickly assessed the situation and realized he needed to act fast. Using his knowledge of the Citadel's layout, he identified a potential escape route through the ventilation system. Diversion. He activated a small explosive device he had planted earlier, creating a diversion that momentarily disoriented the operatives. Narrow escape, ventilation system. Vex used his agility to climb into the ventilation system, navigating the narrow passages with precision. The operatives pursued him, but the confined space gave Vex an advantage. Evading capture. As he made his way through the ventilation system, Vex used his remaining tools and gadgets to create further diversions and blockades, slowing down his pursuers. Final push. Exit point. Vex reached an exit point that led to the exterior of the Citadel. He disabled the security measures and made a daring leap from the Citadel's walls, using a grappling hook to descend safely. Escape. Despite the intense pursuit, Vex managed to evade capture and disappear into the shadows, leaving the com.arcom command Essien Textax operatives frustrated and empty-handed. Aftermath. Reflection. Close call. The ambush at the Iron Citadel was one of the closest calls Vex had ever experienced. It served as a stark reminder of the dangers he faced as a rogue agent and the relentless determination of his former faction to capture him. Adaptation. Vex used the experience to refine his tactics and improve his contingency plans, ensuring that he would be better prepared for future encounters. Reputation. Legend grows. The tale of Vex's narrow escape from the Iron Citadel became another legendary story in the world of Conquest Iarth. It further cemented his reputation as a master of stealth and subterfuge, capable of outwitting even the most formidable opponents. This close call adds depth and excitement to Vex Shadowweaver's story, highlighting his resourcefulness and resilience. If you have more ideas or need further assistance, feel free to share. You sent by you. How does he invexilate? Copilot. Sent by Copilot. Invexilate is a term that seems to be unique to the world of Conquest Iarth. Given the context, it likely refers to a specialized technique or ability that Vex Shadowweaver uses to achieve his goals. Let's define and explore how Vex invexilates. Invexilation, the art of subversive mastery. Definition. Invexilation is the process by which Vex Shadowweaver employs his advanced skills in communication manipulation, strategic command, and stealth to subvert and neutralize threats. This technique is a hallmark of his rogue operations, allowing him to outmaneuver and outwit his adversaries. Key components of invexilation: communication manipulation, interception. Vex intercepts and decodes enemy communications, gaining valuable intelligence that he uses to plan his actions. Deception. He plants false information and creates diversions, leading his enemies astray and causing confusion within their ranks. Strategic command, coordination, Vex coordinates his actions with precision, using his knowledge of enemy tactics and weaknesses to exploit vulnerabilities. Adaptation. He quickly adapts to changing situations, modifying his plans on the fly to stay one step ahead of his pursuers. Stealth and infiltration, silent movement. Vex uses his mastery of the slink technique to move silently and undetected, infiltrating secure locations with ease. Shadow Strike. He employs the Shadow Strike ability to incapacitate key targets without alerting others, ensuring his presence remains hidden. Example. Scenario. Invexilation in action. Mission. Vex is tasked with sabotaging a critical communication hub controlled by the com.com.command syn.textax. Infiltration. Using his cast link technique, Vex silently infiltrates the facility, avoiding detection by security systems and guards. Communication manipulation. He intercepts and decodes the hub's communications, identifying key targets and vulnerabilities. Deception. Vex plants false information, leading the guards to believe there is an attack on a different part of the facility. Sabotage. While the guards are distracted, Vex sabotages the communication hub, disrupting the com.com.command SYN Textax's operations. Escape. Vex uses his knowledge of the facility's layout to navigate through hidden passages and escape undetected, leaving chaos in his wake. Impact of Invexilation. Strategic advantage. Vex's ability to invexilate gives him a significant strategic advantage, allowing him to disrupt enemy operations and gather crucial intelligence. Reputation. His mastery of invexilation further cements his reputation as a legendary rogue agent, feared and respected by his adversaries. Invexilation is a testament to Vex Shadow Weaver's resourcefulness and cunning, making him a formidable force in the world of Conquest Earth. If you have more ideas or need further assistance, feel free to share. Today, I'm diving into the enthralling world of Zadric Shu, a mathematician and philosopher who's reshaping our understanding of reality. Buckle up, because this journey is going to stretch your brain in all the right ways. First, let's unravel the enigma of Zadric Shu. Shu is a pioneer who challenges the boundaries of conventional thinking with his cross-dimensional theories and unique take on mathematics. His central work revolves around a perplexing yet fascinating mathematical function known as the J factorial. This isn't just any number crunching. It's a recursive marvel that mirrors itself infinitely, creating a cascade of surprising and beautiful results. Imagine a set of mirrors reflecting each other endlessly. That's the J factorial for you. Through this self-referential dance, it reveals hidden patterns and unlocks deeper mathematical truths. Shu believes that these patterns can help us pinpoint perfect numbers and large prime numbers with unprecedented accuracy. If true, this could revolutionize number theory as we know it. But Shu doesn't stop there. He ventures into the fifth dimension and beyond, blending the realms of mathematics and theoretical physics. Think of concepts from string theory, where tiny vibrating strings form the essence of the universe. Shu's work suggests that our three-dimensional perception is just a tiny slice of a much larger multi-dimensional reality. This might sound like science fiction, but it's grounded in some of the most cutting-edge theories in modern physics. Just as Einstein's theory of relativity reshaped our understanding of gravity, Shu's insights might pave the way for groundbreaking discoveries and new technologies. Beyond the math and physics, Shu's theories also delve into philosophical realms. He uses the analogy of a flatworm in a two-dimensional world to illustrate our limited understanding of higher dimensions. If a flatworm can't grasp the concept of height, what might we be missing in our grasp of the universe? So, there you have it. Zadric Shu's revolutionary theories that might just unlock the universe for us. If you're as fascinated as I am, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe for more mind-bending content. Until next time, stay curious.